Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In this channel, you will find event styling tips as well as how to start your own decorating business. In today's video, I will be sharing my 5 marketing strategies for a balloon business. If you like videos like this, please don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button below. I will be posting more videos weekly, so stay tuned. Hi guys, welcome back. So as I mentioned before, I will be going over my 5 marketing strategies for your balloon business. So let's get started. Tip number 1, your professional presence. What do I mean by this? Business cards. Yes, just because we live in a social media world, just don't disregard the power of a business card. When you go to places, you're gonna meet a ton of people. So just it's very important that you carry your business cards with you at all times, because when you end up meeting people, it looks more professional to just go ahead and give them a business card as opposed to just writing it in a piece of paper. You certainly do not want to be that type of person, and there are a lot of websites out there that help you create your business cards for an affordable price. Websites such as Vistaprint, Sazzle, even Shutterfly. So just keep that in mind. And one piece of advice, just do not go cheap on your business card. Try to get it as a hard cardstock, because you want to make sure that this business card represents your business and your professionalism. So, you know, it's going to be your first impression to the client. So just keep that in mind. Tip number 2. Friends and family. Yes, word of mouth. That is very important. Maybe find out if a friend of a family member are having a party and volunteer helping with the decorations for free. Once you put your work out there and people at the party see how great you've done, they will want to refer you out. And again, you will have that handy business card to go ahead and share your information with them. So just make sure that you get the word out there. And being that you're starting your business, you're probably not going to book clients right away. So your best clients at this point will be your family and friends, just to get the word out there. Tip number 3, social media. You want to have a online presence. So first, you want to create a website. A website, it's going to serve as a business card, but it's going to be online for clients to find out all the information about your business, such as your contact information, your pictures, your reviews, your pricing. So it is very important to have a website where they can just go and see what you have to offer. But if you do not have the money for it, you can also sign up for Facebook, Pinterest, YouTube, Instagram. All of those social media platforms are great marketing tools, and they work just for free. So make sure that you're constantly posting videos, posting pictures of your work, and stay active, because people do want to see what you have to offer. Tip number 4, your physical portfolio. Yes, it is great to have an online website or a social media platform with all your pictures, but you do want to have a hard copy idea book, because when you do meet with clients, people are very visual, and when you're talking to them and you want to secure the business, you want to make sure that you get your hard copy and show them all the work that you have to offer. Especially if we're talking about corporate, you know, they don't have time to log into your Instagram or check your website sometimes. They just wanna talk to you in person and try to see, okay, what are your ideas? And being that people are very visual, you may have all these ideas in your head and you're trying to tell them and convince them of what you can do for them, but they won't be able to follow you through. So you wanna make sure you show them the idea book, and if they like what they see, then you can go ahead and secure your business. So just keep that in mind. Always have a portfolio with you. And my tip number 5, the last one, but the most important one, will be cold calling. So you're gonna have to put a little bit more effort on this one, because you will wanna call catering halls, restaurants, hotels, any type of store that offers event decorating, party planning, all that stuff. These places are literally having parties or events every week. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna call, pick up the phone, try to speak with the manager and secure a meeting with them. By then you have to show up being very prepared with your information. That means have your business cards, your flyers, even maybe a type up letter of what your services are. So you're gonna wanna sit with them and say, these are the services I would like to provide my services to you. And believe me when I tell you, these people are trying to look for a reliable person. If you do book your first client with them, and let me tell you, you have to do a great work with them, because once they see that, they will want to refer you over and over and over, and you can just sit and relax because the calls will be coming in for you. So just make sure that, again, the work that you put out there is the best work, because you want them to continue to refer you out. And again, not only the manager at the place or the location, but also the people at the party. Think about it. You're killing literally two birds with one stone, right? You're doing marketing with the owner of the business or the manager, but you're also making your pitch to the people at the party. And when they see your work, they're gonna keep you in mind and ask for your business card. So just be ready. And again, just last, don't forget to ask for a review and a referral. You will be surprised how many people are willing to write you a very nice review or even take pictures of your work and post it on social media. Always ask for copies of those pictures, ask them to write a review to put it in your website and to refer you out. Maybe you can say, for every referral that I get from you, you will get a discount from me on your next event. And that's how you continue the loop of marketing. So if you like these type of videos, guys, just please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button below. I will be posting more videos just like this, you know? And I can't wait to talk to you guys on the next video. Thank you for watching.